just been hell. It's been complete hell.
Felita Lyles is the unofficial poster girl for the Live Baltimore campaign. 6 years ago, she bought a home in Upper Fells Point and commutes to her D.C. job. The Washington Post even wrote a feature story about it. As we first reported just before Thanksgiving, city officials condemned her house. An unknown source of water undermined its foundation.
I'm pretty stressed and panicked and freaked.
Since then, the condition of Felita's home has deteriorated. The cracks are more pronounced. The street in front of her house is even sunk. A city inspector determined that the foundation is in the state of collapse. Felita, who couldn't afford to take another day off work to deal with the problem, told us by phone she's puzzled by the notice because she already had a private contractor show her up her property.
Just stacking walls up so that nothing shifts that way.
She says she got this follow-up letter that blew her away. It reads in part, in 30 days, this property must either be rehabilitated or demolished. You have the right to appeal this order. If an appeal is not timely filed, the building official, without further notice, is authorized to demolish the property. The cost of any such action will be a lien against the property and personal debt of the owner. Again by phone, Felita says she's just disgusted by the city's response and fears the problem could bankrupt her. The city estimates that demolition costs between $5,000 to $70,000. Felita's insurance company declined her claim, saying the policy does not cover erosion. And she questions the logic in making repairs before the cause is determined. Private tests of sump pump water show traces of fluoride, a chemical the city uses in drinking water.
Which indicates that this could be a city responsibility.
The city is still trying to determine the source of the problem. Over the weekend, engineers used green dye to follow the water flow. The results point to the possibility that the sewer hookup from the street to Felita's home is not connected properly. The city temporarily shut off water to several homes on the street. When they turned it back on, the water problem disappeared everywhere but at Felita's house. The city engineer is not authorized to talk on camera. He informed neighbors about his theory.
It could possibly be indicative of a compromised pipe underground.